Yeah, it's been obviously a different couple of months than what I thought I was going to have before Christmas. You know, every cloud has a huge silver lining, and spending, you know, 3 months at home has been fantastic, if I'm being honest with you. You know, it's been kind of living a normal life again, which, you know, I haven't had for quite a long time, and it's been great. It's been great spending time with family and friends, and being at home. So, you know, that on that side of it, it has been really refreshing and actually really enjoyable being at home. You're right. That's the challenge on now on the cricket is, you know, obviously lots gone on since that last win at the Oval against India, where we played three outstanding test matches, you know, to come back from 1-0 down that series. And of course, a lot has happened since that time. So to say we can get back there straight away is going to be a challenge for obviously the players and obviously the leadership of me and Morsy to try and do that. Because as I said, the last three test matches we played some good cricket. We've got to focus on the exciting thing, which is the next 5 weeks. And the guys who are lucky enough to pull on that shirt, to represent our country, to be committed to playing for England, and the buzz that those guys got. I was with Adam when he got his phone call from James Whittaker in Dubai, and it was such a refreshing thing to see. You know, the guy, a tough Yorkshireman who is a gritty Yorkshireman at the top of the order, was in tears talking to his mum, and that is what playing cricket for England is. And getting that opportunity for him to be standing, you know, in the airport in his first England suit, he'll remember it forever. And we've got to concentrate on that now. You know, as I said, the three guys at the top of ECB can deal with any of the external stuff. You know, we got a first team meeting in half an hour's time, and that's what I really want to talk to lads about, pulling on that shirt again and putting some real pride back into English cricket. Yeah, so me and Morsy, I've known Morsy for years, and I love working under Peter. And I've had a bit of time away, and one thing I'm looking forward to is leading England again in that first Test match. So, you know, from my point of view, it's all about that. Well, anyone who has actually got to cross over the line and face 90 mile an hour bowlers, Kemar Roach, they've got some really experienced cricketers, will have a very different view. Well, certainly in our team, we've got a very different view to that. We know winning a series away from home takes a huge amount of skill and effort. So we've just got to focus on that. As always, people can say what they want, and you know, it's irrelevant again for us and the guys. We're there to take wickets and score runs. Absolutely. I mean, that's what I've got to do. Top of the order, got to score runs to set up runs for England wins. You saw, you know, there weren't hundreds, but there were 90s and 80s and 70s in those last three games. And runs at the top of the order always make England a harder side to win. And it's the same for any side. I'm not saying that, but the top order runs, you know, you're paid to score runs. And I'd love to get back to lifting up that bat again.